Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Evan Gappelberg. He's the CEO of Nextech AR Solutions. Evan, good to see you again.
Thanks. Great to be back.
So Evan, you've announced that the first quarter of 2023 is currently tracking to be a record quarter for 3D modeling. Is it all down to your groundbreaking generative AI technology?
Yes. So we ended 2022 with record 3D model revenue, and we announced that we had landed Amazon in Q3 2022. That's now flowing into 2023, but more importantly, there's a new tempo, a new pace of 3D model contract wins that I'm seeing away from Amazon. So Amazon is definitely the biggest customer, but now we've also signed Target, and there's a number of other major e-commerce sites that we're now starting to supply 3D models to. So we're seeing the 3D model demand really start to accelerate. The opportunity is massive. And when you combine that with our groundbreaking breakthrough generative AI, which creates the 3D models at scale, which allows us to meet this demand and allows us to have higher profit margins, it really does create the framework for an explosive 2023.
So obviously Amazon and Target are massive customers. Is it feeding through to the merchants who are perhaps using Amazon as well? Are you getting smaller companies coming on board?
Yeah, so Amazon has not opened up their platform yet to their merchants, but that is coming. And so there's an enormous amount of pent-up demand that we're hearing is in the market right now from Amazon. But away from Amazon, you know, we supply hundreds of other e-commerce sites with 3D models, and we're seeing an increased pace in demand. And, you know, it used to be that when we would sign up with a new account, they'd order 25 models to kind of start. Those days are over. We're now getting requests for quotes for 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 5,000 models. And that just never happened before. It was always, you know, the websites would leg in. They would be testing. That testing phase ended really in 2022. And what we're seeing is an acceleration in 2023. And we expect that to continue in a big way when Amazon opens the floodgates, which is expected by the end of Q1. So as we roll into Q2, things should get even more, even bigger demand from our 3D modeling customers.
Evan, as we see the e-commerce market transitioning from 2D to 3D modeling, are you able to keep up with the demand?
I mean, that is going to be our biggest challenge. As of now, we are keeping up with the demand, but you know, the key here, the secret sauce is the AI. A lot of people talk about AI these days. We're actually using generative AI, which is driving record 3D model production in Q1. But more importantly, it's going to continue to allow us to keep pace with demand in Q2, 3, 4, and beyond. And so we're now hiring a chief AI officer and hiring a whole army of AI experts to help us to be able to keep up with the demand, because the demand is going to outstrip supply if we don't do that.
And if you're looking at multi-year contracts here, Evan, I presume that feeds into your ARRs, your annual recurring revenue going forward.
Yeah, the multi-year contracts are super important. I'm glad you pointed that out, because it allows us to invest with confidence in our business and in our teams. You know, prior to really the end of 2022, the 3D modeling business was growing, but you know, not many multi-year contracts. These big enterprise customers, the Amazons, the Targets, and others, they sign multi-year contracts with us. And that gives us the confidence to be able to create a business model that ultimately can go cash flow positive. So that it is important, very, very important to have these multi-year contracts.
Okay, so you're looking at a record first quarter for 2023. Your thoughts for the full year 2023? It's going to be a record year for the company, Evan.
It is, and I'm anticipating that Q1 is going to be a record. Q2 is going to be a record. Q3 is going to really, when it starts to accelerate at a very rapid pace. And I've mentioned in Q4, I think, is when we kind of blow the doors off the barn.
Well, I'm sure you'll keep us posted of all that progress, Evan. Thank you very much for the update today.